What's up, everybody? Y'all already know who it is. Targeted individual CJBK. So, okay. A few things, right? Okay. Now, remember how I said that, you know, they are using like the frequencies to attack, you know, my molar tooth right here, but it has those like metal like fillings. I think at this point, because, well, obviously metal is a conductor of energy, they are using that as like a think of the metal rods in a nuclear reactor, right? I believe they are using those to basically hold or retain the energy that then heats up my tooth, right? And the tooth, of course, is encasing the nerve. So as it's heating up the tooth, and then it's, you know, the tooth heating up is touching the nerve, you know, that's what causes pain. But here's the funny thing. Anything I do to cool down the tooth, that's when the pain actually goes away. So let's say if I took this. If I take a sip of something really cold, it doesn't hurt when I take a sip of something cold. When I take a sip of something cold, it actually stops hurting completely. Think of like how, you know, in a nuclear reactor, they surround the metal rods, the iron rods, or whatever. Yeah, they surround the iron, you know, rods with cold water. So basically, I figured that also helps. But yeah, they're definitely taking advantage of that. So there's definitely been moments, at least especially today. And I think they're going to use that as their price point, I'm going to say. Because they're like, it's funny because I gave them the idea to attack my teeth. I actually gave them the idea about what? I want to say about 3 to 5 weeks ago. Because, you know, sometimes I talk junk and I'll just be like, you know, I don't know why, you know, they gave y'all the, you know, all this weapon and technology. Because I was like, y'all don't even understand the psychology of certain things. I was like, if you're going to try to give someone pain, the first thing that you would want to go for is their teeth. And I said that. And then next thing you know, a few weeks later, all of a sudden they started, you know, hitting me in my teeth. So I was just like, okay, so I gave him a bone. And now they're like really happy now because they see me struggling, right? But at the end of it all, it's kind of like, well, you do realize I gave you the idea so that I can actually understand more about your technology, right? You do realize that, right? So it's like, I tell them all the time, I said, look, God is with me everywhere I go, no matter what I'm doing. Even if I go out on a town with some friends and have a bit too much to drink, and then next thing you know, I'm like, you know, sleep on the subway or something. But, you know, and that type of stuff happens anyway, you know, whatever. But anyway, but yeah, so they're basically using directed energy against that. And crazy thing is, remember how resonant frequencies work? You know, if you find the frequency of a particular thing and when you tune your frequency generator to the frequency of whatever that thing is that you're trying to aim to cause a reaction to, it will cause it to, like, the cells, the molecular or chemical or structural cells of that thing will start to vibrate so viciously that it will generate heat. And then as it generates heat, that's when eventually it will break. So the whole thing now is to try to attack this one tooth, if not all of my teeth, but they're attacking this one tooth. More specifically, especially since it has two fillings in the molar. I've been feeling like, what's my man Tom Hanks' name in Castaway? I forgot. But yeah, when he decided to, like, knock that tooth out all on his own. But anyway. Okay, so, boom, I realized I can use something cool to cool it down, because it's working, like, they're working it just like it's a, you know, just like how they would use the metal rods in a coolant tank at a nuclear reactor. Now, okay, the second thing I wanted to hit on is, I recently had a meetup, right? Or I did a I met up with some other TIs here in New York City. Met up with some other TIs, and one of them, dear sweet woman, her mom is actually being attacked by these secret society of gang stalkers and whatnot. And her mom gotta be about like 80 plus years old. And I'm just thinking about it. I'm just like, that's a shame. That's really a shame. That's some cold blooded, that's some cold blooded stuff right there. Like, you're attacking elderly people with this technology? I mean, that's some cold-blooded stuff right there when you think about it. They're attacking elderly women, you know. And then what makes it really sad is that the perps who are attacking me and my mother, you know, they're black. You know, they oftentimes like to say, oh, you don't realize you're snitching on everybody. You messing with people's livelihoods. Oh, you know, you're not supposed to know about technology. Da, 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 da. And I'm just like, after meeting up with them, it was my friend with her mother, myself, and then two other guys. One of the gentlemen, he said that he's been targeted for like 35 years, but the electronic, you know, stuff really didn't start till about like 10 years ago. And I was like, it makes sense, because that's when, you know, the cell towers started to, you know, really become more and more powerful and upgraded, you know, as we grew through the, you know, first generation, second generation, third generation. Well, 10 years ago, I think we were probably at 3G 10 years ago already. 10 years ago, maybe about 3 or 4G 10 years ago. And by that point, people probably already knew how to build their own cell phone tower. So if you have an iPhone, right? If you have an iPhone, there's an app that I think everyone should definitely get. Every TI, if you have an iPhone, you should definitely check out this app. You do have to pay like $2.99 for it, but I think it's completely worth it. It's called The Architecture of Radio, right? I have several videos from the past where I've posted on YouTube, and it shows like satellites, it shows Wi-Fi routers, and it shows cell towers. But here's the funny thing about the cell towers, right? Each of the displayed cell towers would usually show who, like referring to company, is that cell tower registered to, right? It would say T-Mobile. If it's T-Mobile, it would say AT&T. If it's AT&T. But there are several cell towers that are listed as unknown carrier. And then I found out probably about like what, 2 weeks ago, that people can actually build their own cell towers. I didn't realize you can build your own cell tower, but that in itself, I was like, okay, so when I start to see a lot more unknown carrier cell towers pop up around my vicinity when I'm using the Architecture of Radio app. So I was just like, okay, so I think they basically, oh, well, there's also the Stingray device too. So they probably are using the Stingray device, because a Stingray device basically, acts as if it is a cell phone tower, and it snoops up other people's phones, because whenever you're using your cell phone and your cell phone needs to gain access to a network, if a Stingray is nearby, your phone will connect. Your phone will, it will, no matter what, your phone will connect to the Stingray and act, and respond to that Stingray as if it's a cell tower. So, okay, then, and just remember, they're using these cell towers to basically send out their millimeter wave, frequency attacks, and I think the directed energy is to amplify our electromagnetic field, so that it's much easier as they send the directed energy to our magnetic field. I think it amplifies our frequencies, right? So then when they're using their millimeter waves to basically find and locate certain parts of our body and everything, it picks up on the specific frequency that they're trying to dial into, and then once they send their frequency to us, and then it resonates with that body part or whatever, that's when they can lock on, and then they could be able to tune or amplify the frequency however they want to create whatever result that they want. Anyway, that was number two. But yeah, I'm just like, so after that meetup I did, they're like attacking elderly people, and when you think about it, I'm just like, a lot of this stuff is definitely all about money, and property, money and property, money and property, money, property, and control. Narcissists love the idea of control. Narcissists love to have control over people. Nothing makes a narcissist happier than knowing they have control over someone. And what's even better is when you can actually put someone who's in a particular economical situation to where that person may need money anyway, right? That person may need benefits. That person may need, whatever type of that person may need whatever type of help they can get, right? Now, think about it like this. If you live in a certain area where there's like no snitching, right? if you tell someone, look, we gonna help you out, but you gotta do something for us, and then, you know, the person, you know, one, the person is already freaked out by the fact that they hear a voice, you know, being transmitted into their brain, and they don't know where the hell it's coming from, but, you know, they know that it's already weird enough that somebody can actually transmit their voice into their head. You know, they don't realize it's frequencies, but yeah, it's frequencies. And then you think about the idea that, you know, if the person does eventually find out, the electronic handler actually can decode your memories, which are encoded in your brain as frequencies. So think about it like this. Let's say your PIN number or any type of information that you save in your brain, it's saved as a frequency, right? What they do, what the electronic handlers do, is they basically get someone who is on foot. They would call them a flying monkey, or that's what I found online. They call it a flying monkey. Flying monkey is like someone who is like a perp that assists others, and they will also lie in order to make sure that the nefarious job gets done, right? The perp or flying monkey or on the field gang stalker would triangulate with the electronic handler by, you know, whatever means, you know, especially if you're in an apartment building, you know, they'll do things like drop something on the floor but right above your head. Like, it'll be distinctually right above your head. Like, it's not like it would be over there or over there. No, wherever you're sitting at, you would randomly hear something just drop right above your head. And then if you were focused on watching TV or something like that, the moment that you hear that sound, it kind of like breaks your brainwave concentration, right? From, like, if you were watching TV or reading a book, it would break your concentration. And then that leaves like an opening. So then if the electronic handlers were already trying to see if they can, you know, get your resonant frequency, and then the moment that they drop something above your head, it'll break that concentration, and then you're like, and then as soon as that open is in, boom, that transmission, it goes through. Remember, it's not going through your ears because you're not going to hear it. It's going to go through the skull and directly into the brain. Then, once they break your concentration, boom, they got your resonant frequency. So it's like they triangulate it with you. Then what else? But yeah, I'm like, it's so weird, like, cause I went online before I like started meeting like a lot of other TIs here in New York City, New Jersey, Connecticut. I, you know, was going online and I would read or watch videos about other TIs, like from across the country, across the world. And, you know, they would tell me their, you know, they would explain their stories about how, like, they feel sexually assaulted, you know, because remember, you know, all of this attack, though it may not be like someone, you know, hands-on doing these things to them, remember, your body is filled with probably like billions of nerves, right? So, and your body is like a huge electrical, you know, it's like your body's like a huge computer or something like that. Well, the brain works more like a computer, but anyway, with this technology, they can basically make you feel like someone is doing something to your body, right? Because remember, this is all nerves. We're talking about nerves. This is the nervous system we're talking about. So, you know, think about it. If you're like, you're having sex, if your nervous system wasn't acting properly while you were having sex, you wouldn't feel anything. You wouldn't feel yourself being penetrated. You wouldn't feel yourself going into somebody. But then think about if someone can actually access your nervous system and not even actually physically touch you, but they can access your nervous system. Just imagine women complaining, you know, about, you know, feeling like someone had sex with them, but, you know, no one was there. They have the feeling like someone had sex with them. Like, they, and ladies, you know what that feels like. And then, you know, same thing for guys. But the part that got me was when, you know, I've seen, you know, videos where a child said that they felt like someone did something to them while they were, like, in their room trying to sleep. You know, whatchamacallit. Even like there, you know, there are videos and testimonies where children are saying that, like, you know, they got burned, you know, while they were in their sleep. And, you know, some of them would have physical markings, some of them may not. So it just dawns on me, and I'm just thinking to myself, like, so all these people that's working with this so-called secret society of gang stalkers, right? They're cool with the idea that there are people walking around who have this technology that's able to do this type of stuff to, you know, women, children, elderly, men, you know. And I'm just like, they're cool with it. And then some of them are parents themselves. That's the sick part to me. That's the sick part to me. Some of them are actually parents themselves. And maybe they need to actually go online and look at the videos themselves. Maybe that's what they need to do. Maybe they need to actually go online and look up testimonials of targeted individuals and just see it for themselves. Maybe they just need to do that. But I don't think they're going to do that. Why? Because they're on the other side. They're on the other side where, we not getting attacked. You the one getting attacked. We don't give a fuck about y'all. So they all happy about it, right? You know, and it is what it is. Some people really just don't care about other people. As long as they're good, they don't care. They really don't care. All right. I'm done with that thought. Another one. I should be getting my thermal camera either somewhere between today and Friday. No, not today. Tomorrow and Friday. So I can't wait to play around with that. Because I like how just now I start to hear the footsteps right above my head. They're about to get busy. Not like freaky busy, but they're about to, like, as soon as I stop recording, they're about to, you know, do whatever gang stalking activity that they do. Anyway. What else? Remember, if you have decided, let me tell you, this book right here, Crystal Healing by Judy Hall, this book is really, really informative. I'll show you a snippet of, let me see. Nope. Past the page I wanted to go to. Hold on, bear with me for a second. Oh, wait, there we go. Okay. Now, notice this, right? This is basically the anatomy of the aura, or your electromagnetic field that comes from your body, right? And you can, well, it's in reverse, but if anyone would like to see pictures, you know, of it, you know, in its proper form or whatever, let me know. I can, you know, either email you some excerpts from this book or whatever, but just take note of that, right? Now, one thing I've learned from this whole ordeal is when I'm using the healing crystals, or if I'm using, you know, the neodymium magnet on the skin, they basically have encased a, 'cause like when I do this, I could feel like a release of pressure already, like right over my skin. When I do this, it's almost as if there's like a film of, or like a, like some type of layer of energy, like a foreign energy that's not mine. Because every time I do it, there's like a sense of release. There's like a relief, rather, not a release, but a relief. So they have encased our bodies with this man-made bombardment of unnatural energy, right? This is how they're amplifying our frequencies. They're using the directed energy to basically amplify our frequencies to make it easier for them to be able to find and locate every specific, you know, part of us. What else? But yeah, definitely consider buying this book if you want to get into healing crystals. As you can see, I'm using mine because my TV is right in front of my bed. I'm using mine to try to absorb as much of the energy that's coming from the TV. I also have my Organite pyramid. But you know, if you decide to invest in, you know, crystals, remember you have to actually cleanse them after a while, or else they won't, you know, they won't be able to be as effective. What else? Oh, and another thing, this is probably gonna be my last thought. You know, like I said, you know, I live in New York City, and you know, New York City is probably home of about like what, 8 million people, maybe 9 million people. And with that many people clustered in one, you know, particular area, you already know that there's probably crime and everything happening everywhere. Now, like I said, you know, I grew up, you know, I grew up, you know, never being a snitch. I never snitched on nobody a day in my life. Like, never snitched on nobody a day in my life. And I always mind my business. And I always stayed in my own lane. Now, the thing that I really hate about all this is that these people basically are trying to push me to join, or that, not even join. They were basically extorting me, or trying to coerce me into being a part of them. I don't do nothing that I don't consciously accept that I want to do. I don't care how many people it is, who it is, I will not be told or forced to do something that I did not consciously want to do. So their whole thing is like, oh, you know, you weren't supposed to tell nobody about the technology and whatnot, so now you a snitch. And I'm like, first of all, how am I a snitch? Because I was like, one, this is one of the most craziest ideas ever, to really realize that someone is using technology to basically gain access to your human body and then manipulate your nervous system, your dreams, you know, and try to see if they can induce a psychological illness in you. All of this is just wild. They're using frequency to try to give me a shin splint, I guess. But yeah. Now, along with that, they're basically trying to say that they got so many people hooked into this, right? And I remember watching this video where this woman, she was so adamant. She's like, I'm an advocate against, you know, these nefarious groups using directed energy and frequencies. They're like a hidden network. They have like secret servers on, private servers online where they, where they're, you know, torturing people and people can log in. It's just like red rooms in a dark web. You know, if you look up Peter Scully, you know, it's just like that, but it's even worse. You know, so I was watching her videos and she was talking about, yeah, they're using the technology to rape babies and children and women. They love to go for women who are like single parents and stuff like that. And I was just like, you know, yeah, you hear him, right? Anyway, so now I'm just like, yo, there's no way I can join something like this. I could never allow myself to be a part of something like this. And one of the things that I know for certain is that, there's so much happening on the news. And remember, always remember, before the elites decide that they want to do something, right? They put it on the news first. They're going to have a story for it. They're going to have a story for it, and they're going to put it on the news. Once they have met a certain, I guess, goal or a threshold in something that's happening to society, they're going to allow the news to finally report it. Think about UFOs. How many decades went by before they started, how many decades went by where people, you know, were, you know, talking about, oh, they came in contact with a UFO did this stuff to their brain, da da da. And we all, if you know, most of us basically said, oh, you're crazy, you know, UFO's not real, blah blah blah. And now all of a sudden, look, now they're reporting UFOs on mainstream media. Like, they're reporting it on like CNN, MSNBC, like all the major and, you know, local news places are reporting UFOs. You know, the government done declassified, you know, evidence and proof that UFOs are real and that there's, you know, extraterrestrial beings out in the universe and whatnot. You know, now they're declassifying it. And then you look at Havana Syndrome, you know, all of them, you know, all 200 plus U.S. personnel were all complaining about, you know, hearing of, you know, extremely high frequency noises, the symptoms of, you know, feeling like, you know, nausea, dizziness, vertigo, you know, all kinds of things happening to their head, you know, loss of vision, all kinds of things, you know, like basically the feeling of being concussed without actually, you know, having a physical blunt force trauma to the head. You know, that's exactly what they're doing to us, right? These perps, these electronic handlers, that's exactly what they're doing to us. So remember what I'm saying. Remember what I'm saying, because I kid you not. My theory is someone is going to bite the bullet for this. And the way that the elite tends to work is they'll put it out. They'll put out the information in the media, whether it be television shows, movies, or the news. They'll put it out first. And then they're going to find someone to blame. Because remember, a lot of this is all kind of like a big experiment to see if they can control populations. Eugenics, in a sense, right? So just imagine, they're already aware, trust and believe, they're already aware that people are using the radio waves and everything. They're already aware of this. It's not a secret. They're running an experiment, right? And just think about it. The Army, Navy, Air Force, NASA, they already possess the technology to find every single person using these frequencies, right? They already have the technology to find them. Like, no sweat. You know, it doesn't matter if they're trying to hide their frequencies, you know, within another frequency or anything like that. You know, double wide band frequency. It doesn't matter if they're, you know, using that. They already possess the technology to find them. It's only but a matter of time before they finally start to paint the picture. Right now they're trying to say, oh, it's Russia, oh, it could be China, blah, blah, blah. It's only but a matter of time before they start to say out loud and very, very present. Because remember, they're probably using this as a tool to say, we need to have the government create some type of device that, you know, protects the American brain, right? And they'll say, there's these nefarious domestic terrorists using this technology, and, you know, in order to protect Americans, we gotta protect their brains from these groups. And then, you know, they'll say that, you know, we have been able to locate these groups, and they're all throughout the U.S., you know. Trust and believe, they're going to paint a picture like that. And when they finish painting that picture, I'm going to just say it now, look at God. Because they think they're undetectable. They think nobody knows. They think, you know, they're just basically going to get away with everything that they're doing. I'm putting it out there in the universe. And God, ooh, guardian angels, Christ, well, I believe Jesus was like a target individual myself. If you read the book of John and how, you know, how the Jews basically treated Jesus, Christ was definitely a T.I. He was definitely a target individual. But look, watch. They are about to flip the script so hard on every single person using these devices. I don't know when it's going to happen, but they are going to flip the script on every single one of them. Because you got to think about it like this. They already know, they're already trying to get rid of the, you know, physical guns, the bullet guns and everything. They're already trying to get rid of that. And then now they're talking about direct energy weapons. So trust and believe, watch. Keep your eyes open. They are going to flip the script and talk about that these direct energy weapons and how people are using frequencies and building fake cell towers themselves, or, using stingray devices to do all these nefarious things to people's, you know, nervous systems and things of that sort. They're going to flip the script, and then they're going to, once they grab one person and find out how many people he has connected, they're probably going to say, you know, funny thing is, these perps probably have it already organized in their cell phone or in their laptops or on the website, you know, some dark web website. They probably already have it organized and categorized by, you know, just for example, victims, you know, snitches, victims. Then they probably got it as wealthy people. Because remember, remote neural monitoring, you could basically see everything they're seeing. I don't know if people are wearing probably not wearing a headset at all, but they can, if their brain is already kind of hooked up to the cloud, then they can feel what another person feels or something like that. So there's going to be a moment where one of them is going to get caught, and then it's going to open like a can of worms. Every single person that was either targeted by it or every single person that's working with them. And I kid you not, I would rather be the victim. I would rather be the victim. I'm going to say it one more time. I would rather be the victim than to be the person that was working with them. Because when the elite finally flipped that switch and they flipped the story on everybody and start pointing fingers at everybody who has access to this, because think about it, why in the world would the elites who control the radio waves, who control the frequencies and stuff that's being, you know, emitted out in the world, why would they grant so many people access to this if they didn't already have an agenda ahead of time? You gotta think about that. Why would they grant them access? And they're like, because they're a secret society. No, there's levels to secret societies. That's one thing that I learned. There's levels to secret societies. They still don't realize they're the pawns. They still don't realize they're the pawns. And, you know, he's like really going back and forth. And, you know, the beauty of it all is psychologically, I had him beat months ago. They say the one who has the most to lose, the one who is the most afraid, the one who is basically the scariest one, is the one who is the loudest. And it's crazy because I'm hearing him through the synthetic telepathy. He is yelling. He's trying to see if he can, like, keep everybody from, you know, putting the cup down. You know, he's yelling. He's like, he's, you know, he's lying. He's, you know, he's yelling, which means he's scratching and clawing. Me, I'm the victim. I'm the victim. You know. I don't know what they promised everybody. They promised them money. They promised them access to benefits because, you know, they done got so many people hooked into this system. You know, people who work in, you know, various different, you know, jobs and whatnot. So if you're a part of the gang stalk, and then it's like you get that hidden thumbs up to, you know, you could jump the line or blah, 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 whatever. But at the end of the day, if you're not a victim in all of this, you are most definitely going to be a target to the ones that, you know, shoot, even I probably worry about. But actually, no, I don't even really worry about nobody like that, because I already know how, you know, messed up and cruel the world truly is. So, But yeah, I'm gonna end on that note. I gotta cleanse my beads, cause I mean, of course, they're using like an unlimited source of unnatural energy against us. So I would have to be cleansing these beads like every day, and it's not that hard to cleanse these stones and crystals. You know, you could use like running water, or if you live by a beach, you know, like salt water, you know, ocean or something like that. You could just put them in there, and that cleanse it. You know, once you run it under water, you place it under some moonlight, sunlight for a few hours, and boom, you know, you restore the properties of the stones and crystals. Anyway, yeah, that's all I got for today. You know, I gotta check in with y'all just to let y'all know. I'm still here. I'm still here. But yeah. Remember, take life one breath, one thought, one step, one day at a time. Life is a marathon, not a sprint. And remember, God is always watching. If you have been chosen to be a victim in all this and you did not consent to their to working with them or doing whatever they're trying to demand you to do, trust and believe you chose right, because we all still go somewhere after we leave our vessels. After we die and we leave these bodies, we still go somewhere. Remember, energy is never destroyed, it's only transferred. So think about it like that. And I don't want to spend an eternity. I don't want to spend an eternity not resting. No. An eternity of pain, suffering, guilt. All because, you know, I was struggling with my decision making here on Earth. Nah, I'm good. An eternity is a long, long time. That's forever. Anyway, peace out. They try to attack me in my throat, like right here. I don't know if you heard the Morse code car horn outside. I already know when I hang up, they're about to try to go hard. All right, y'all. Good night.